everyone, Alexa Dunn here, and today I am talking about 5 reasons why most writers quit. The reality is, everyone wants to write a book, but most people can't hack it, and even among those who do, most of them are going to give up on taking it further than that first book and on publishing. But why? Well, first of all, ideas are cheap. Ideas are a dime a dozen. Anyone can have a halfway decent idea, and in fact, most people do. This is where everyone wants to write a book comes from. Maybe not literally everyone, but doesn't it feel like anytime you tell someone you're a writer, they go, "Ah, I want to write a book," and they might even start rattling off their idea to you. If you're on writers' forums, you see it all the time, especially my old friend Reddit. Everyone has an idea. But the second reason most people quit and they don't get past the idea stage is that writing is hard. The ideas come easy, but actually writing them, turning an idea into a book, is really, really hard. It seems overly simplistic to tell you, well, writing is hard, but it is. And if you've done it, you know this, but it's hard to kind of communicate that to a novice writer, how hard writing actually is. And not just writing, but finishing the thing. Why is writing hard? Writing is hard because if you're driven by your muse and solely by your muse, by your idea, you're going to run out of steam eventually because novels are really, really long. And let's say you don't specifically run out of steam, they take a long time. Let's say you have steam, but the steam is like a slow and steady push. It can take years and years and years to write a book. Writing is hard because you have to get a lot of elements in play with each other at the same time. It's grammar and it's usage, it's prose style, it's understanding what words mean and how to use them effectively, it's show versus tell, it's creating kind of evocative imagery but without bogging it down, and crafting well-rounded characters who are interesting and do something, and but also the pacing has to be on target. I mean, I could go on forever. There are innumerable craft topics and writing topics. There's a reason that not just anyone can write a novel, and even if they can write a novel, that it isn't necessarily good, because writing is really, really hard. The sheer hours, just the butt in chair, the doing it when you don't want to, the doing it even though it's not always great. That's another thing about writing that is hard that people can't always deal with. Writing is actually rewriting. It's not about vomiting out a perfect draft, because very few people do that, and certainly not on their first book. There is a lot of critically engaging with your work and doing rewriting, and honestly, a lot of people just can't hack it. The third reason most people quit is writing is work. Writing is often, but not always, a job. It is at least a part-time job if you are juggling it on top of other things. Now, it's totally fine to be a hobby writer, but when you're a hobby writer, you know you're a hobby writer. I'm talking about people who quit the wanting to be a professional writer hustle, and it is work. You have to do it when you don't want to. You have to not do things you want to do and write instead. This means fewer social engagements, less watching television. You don't get to go everywhere you want to when you want to go there. There's just so much butt and chair that comes with writing that a lot of people aren't prepared to do. They're not prepared to make those sacrifices to treat writing like a job to get the work done. And again, just the disclaimer, I am always very hesitant at the writing is a job mantra because I think it puts undue and unfair pressure on hobbyist writers, and most of us are hobbyist writers until we're not hobbyist writers. And when you're ready to make that transition, you're ready to make that transition. But the point is, many writers can't make the transition. They don't want to. They give up because it's just, it's too hard, it's too much work, and they'd rather be doing something else, which is fine. The fourth reason so many writers quit is rejection. Rejection is everywhere in writing and in publishing, at every single level, and it never stops. You're going to get rejected when you're trying to find people to read your draft. You're going to be rejected when you query agents, if you query agents. You're going to be rejected by editors at publishers, or if you do the self-publishing route, or also in traditional publishing, you will be rejected by readers. That happens all the time. Sometimes you know it, sometimes you don't. Nothing more awkward than like seeing a Twitter or an Instagram conversation where someone goes, I don't want to read that. It happens to all of us. But you'll also be rejected in the form of reviews. That can be reader reviews or trade reviews. You'll be rejected. Sometimes you've been published once, but your next book is rejected. You can be socially rejected by your fellow writers. I mean, I could go on. The rejection is never ending. It never stops, and it always hurts. But to hack it, you do have to develop coping mechanisms and try to take enough of that rejection and have it make you stronger. And honestly, many, many writers just give up. This includes those who make it, so to speak, those who do get published. A lot of them will wash out because the rejection is just too much. It batters their spirit. And ultimately, writers are, we're creative beings. Many of us are sensitive, and sensitivity is not a bad thing. Sensitivity actually enables so many of us to write compelling, empathetic fiction. But the hard part is you have to basically learn to protect that sensitivity, that part of yourself that fuels your creativity, while dealing with all of this rejection. And honestly, a lot of people just wash out of the industry because they can't take it. And I don't really blame anyone who does that. But even on the more novice level, I see just plenty of people give up because they can't even take the tiniest bit of rejection. One, two people on the query level, for example, says no, and they go, you don't understand me. You don't understand my art. I am a genius. F you. And they walk away. And it's kind of like, good riddance. Did we really lose anything? Because frankly, there are so many writers who can replace them. Ultimately, most writers are replaceable. It's depressing. Well, and so the fifth reason that so many writers give up and don't make it is there is never enough money. This is, of course, about the professional side, people who want to write full time. And honestly, it is a dream and remains a dream for the majority of writers writing fiction full time. There are ways for you to hustle and combine lots of different income streams and do various kinds of writing to be a professional writer. So I do offer that as hope. But it is also just a reality check that professional fiction writing is really difficult when it comes to the balance of being paid for your work. Most of us simply don't get paid enough, and it's really tricky to make the ends meet, where you have to do the ROI of how much work you put into something versus what you're getting back for it and if it's worth it to you. It can just be really demoralizing to put a ton of work into a book, and every writer works just as hard on their book as another writer works on their book, but some get disproportionately paid than other people, and it can just really get to you. But also super practically, if the money just isn't enough, we have to do something else to support ourselves and support our families. And so many people have to give up because there's just not enough money. And it can just be someone kind of having to go back from being a professional writer to being a hobbyist writer, or really just that professional writing always remains a part-time thing because there's just never enough money. Unless you're a unicorn and you get really, really lucky. And we all hope that we become a lucky unicorn. So that's it. Five reasons people give up on writing, specifically professional writing, fiction writing. And if you're out there as an aspiring writer, hopefully this gives you an idea of some of the punches that are gonna come your way and what makes writing and sticking with writing so very hard. But also, don't beat yourself up if any of these things do present a challenge to you. Of course, I encourage you to just push through any of these things that lead most people to quitting. Because the secret is, people who are successful in writing, the most successful people in writing, never gave up. And that's the key. You have to keep pushing. You have to just roll with these punches in order to get where you want to be. And of course, there's tons of nuances that I didn't cover because this is a punchy listicle video. Like, for example, as hard as writing is and as much as writing is work, when you really love writing, you make it fun even when it's hard. And that's really important. I do think that most writers who do stick with it and don't give up do find that joy in the writing even when it's hard. So ultimately, this video is about the people who like the idea of writing, but aren't really just in it for the long haul. They don't have what it takes, and that's fine. So what I say to you is, when they're complaining on Reddit, you don't have to respond, because ultimately it's like, bye. Really, I find anyone who's looking for an easy answer of how do you write and how do you do XYZ isn't going to make it. There are no easy answers in something as hard as this creative consumer business of writing and finding readership and, you know, getting your book in the hands of people who will read it. It's hard no matter what you end up doing, what kind of books you're writing or how you publish them. It's really difficult, but hopefully you're here and you're doing it because you love it, because that's why we do this. We love it, even when it's hard. Let me know down below in the comments, what are some reasons you've seen that people have given up on writing? And give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. I'll make more deeply depressing videos about things about writing in the industry that are really, really hard. If you're not already subscribed to the channel, go ahead and do that. I post new videos 2 to 3 times a week. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, guys, happy writing.